you understand what I'm saying? Your ZNP is creating very defined forms inside, right? There is a triangle which is getting created when ZNP is getting locked, and the counter space of P. So these are very defined forms. So what is happening is that this person has an inside world which is very private to them, and which is their own world in which they feel comfortable. So to me, that triangle and that counter of P reflects that world. That's how I am interpreting it. Okay. But there can be many iterations that you can think of. Okay.
So just to add on here, you know, this is something maybe if you look at it constantly, you might derive on to certain, understanding that you've shown. But when you look at it at the first glance, that is not something that it gets communicated directly. So try to explore, what was the word again that you tried to depict? Shy, what was it? Reserved?
Introverted.
Introverted, okay. So, if you see the thickness, the kind of type that you've used, the thickness of it doesn't necessarily help us think that instantly. Maybe the way you formed it, perhaps could. So try to see that how else visually, what would come to your mind when you want to reflect one of the characteristics which is introverted. So try exploring more and then see as compared to this then.
And another thing that you could do is you start reading about introverted people. Okay. They may not necessarily speak up in public, but they are deep thinkers. Okay.
Yes.
And they do have their very independent way of thinking. Okay. They are not party lovers. They are not very comfortable around people, but they do have an independent thought process. So you can explore with thinness of the weight as well, but sometimes, you know, how you described introverted may also go with a heavier stroke. So explore at the moment. I'm saying read about how introverts behave, and then also you can come up with more visual interpretation. So be open. Okay. You explore with different strokes, but you should be able to justify why you went with a thinner stroke as well.
Yes, yeah. Ma'am.
And why, if you're doing a heavier stroke, why heavier stroke? But this cannot be a superficial thought. If you're saying introverted, read about how introverts are and understand that concept of introverts very, very well. How and the opposite also. How do extroverts behave and how do introverts behave? And how does it align with your client?
Okay.
So this is going to be a very, very multi-layered kind of an assignment wherein you have to understand, and it's not just these letters. The letters have to speak.
Yes, ma'am.
And this has to be a great composition. It has to be aesthetic. It has to be strong enough to be used as an identity. Okay.
Okay. Thank
you. A lot of things will be there, yeah. You'll also reduce it to a size to see whether it's working in that size or not, a smaller size or not. So it is a multi-layered kind of an assignment. You have to think of a lot of things. So it's a good starting point, I would say, but explore.
Okay.
So Sakina is showing us now. Sakina, what are the letters? S and? Sakina? Yeah.
Ma'am, it's J, S and J. So I wanted to show caring. So the S would be around J, something like that. I've also explored more.
Yeah. So go back to what you've shown earlier, because I want to, and everybody should also listen. Everybody has to listen, because the feedback that works for one may work for
others. Video, please mat aao, please mat aao.
Who did you shoo away? Anyways, so you see the J, letter J has lost its identity. In what you're showing, letter J has lost its identity. Both the letters have to be clearly identified. I should be able to see S as S and J as J, which is not happening in this case. Okay? Turn your book around.
So ma'am, this side is introverted, so I thought I'll make a box and that, then write S and J to show a little introvert side. And this is the same for caring.
Yeah, so that box idea is good. Now you see how you develop it further. It has to have visual balance. What kind of lettering are you going to be doing? All those things, thickness, thinness of strokes, a combination of S and J in different strokes or the in different weights or the same weights, all those things need to be figured out. Okay. And I like that S and J on top. What is the characteristic that you're showing there? No, before that, before that. Before that. Yeah, this one.
Okay, yeah, ma'am, that is the same caring one.
How is it caring?
That, like, I was thinking to, like, the S is surrounded around J. So I was just thinking in the way that I'll just make something which will be surrounded or sort of in
so
in
this
the
looks
other
very three-dimensional. Is this deliberately three-dimensional, what you've done here, S and J?
Yes.
Okay, I like that approach very, very much. Visually, very interesting approach. Caring or not caring is something I'm still debating in my head. But as a visual approach, it's a beautiful approach. So you can explore it further, visually at least.
Okay. Thank you.
Yeah. And now keep developing your ideas more. Oh, so Ankit, what is it? ANS? What is the characteristic that you're talking about?
Nature loving.
See, like I said, that you can't use the full patti if you're talking about nature. You can't show trees, you can't show animals, you can't. You just have to use the letter forms. This is an assignment in expressive typography. However, we are saying that don't use any graphics.
What if I just remove the leaves then?
Yeah, I mean, so what is the, when you're saying nature, are you talking about flora?
Yeah.
Right? So what is the characteristic of plants and trees and shrubs? They grow. Right. So how will you show growth without using any graphics? Through letter forms. So bring in the characteristics of nature without showing any graphics.
Okay.
So you have to understand, you have to, have you done in your basic typography course expressive typography? You have? No.
No.
You know what is expressive typography? Are you hearing this term for the first time?
I have a sort of idea of it.
You've never heard the term expressive typography?
I have heard of it, but not really know exactly what it
is. I'm asking not just Ankit. I mean, as a class, I want to ask this question. Do you all know what is expressive typography? You all know? Yeah. So I would suggest as a homework, there are lots and lots of good options of expressive typography, which you can see on Pinterest. So go and have a look, especially the ones in which graphics have not been used. Okay, especially the ones in which graphics have not been used. I want you to open your mind a little. Okay, that's a homework for you all. Everybody is going to do that. And the repository that we are creating, okay, the repository we are creating, have you all put your presentations in the common Google folder? Has everybody put? Yeah. So when you are doing some referencing of expressive typography without graphics of different words, everybody start adding to that common folder, which means create another folder, write expressive, give the title expressive typography to that folder, and everybody adds to that resource. Okay, please do that. So that if you're looking at five good options and the other person is looking at another five good options, we should create a pool of resources so that everybody is able to see. Okay? This is your homework for today. You have to do this. All right. Who else wants to show?
I've tried something else. Is this allowed? Like,
yeah, you can interlock and all those things you can do. But
I've gone for the aspect of cinema lover or a photography lover, and I've tried to manipulate the S as a camera film around the A.
You explore as of now. We'll see. We'll take a call. Let's have now 10 options. Basically, broadly, you've got an idea. But graphics are avoidable, as much as possible.
Okay.
Yeah? Yes. Vivek ka dekhte hain, because Vivek has not shown anything so far.
Ma'am, so the adjective I've chosen was reasonable. Like, I tried to arrange.
What do you mean when you say reasonable? What do you mean?
Ma'am, I mean like behind all the actions there is some reason or the other.
What could be another word for reason as in logical?
Practical.
Do you mean logical?
Yes, ma'am. Logical. Like, I'm trying to show like there's a reason behind every action you take. That's why I try to align all the letters one behind the other to show like there's a reason behind each action.
Okay, so what are the letters R and what is
RMC? That's his full name.
I can't very clearly see the C. What is after R?
M.
So what's the person's name?
Rishabh Mohan Chatterjee.
So you're taking RMC and not RNC?
Yes, ma'am. I'm taking the whole name. Yes, ma'am.
Is he okay with it? Or he wants you to do with R and C only?
No, I'm okay with it.
You're okay with it. So I can't identify the letter M in this. Can you, Krina? I can't identify.
Ma'am, if you make, if you just have another at the presenter's view, you'll be able to look at it closely. On the top right, there's a tab. So if you just press that, you'll be able to see Vivek's screen as an entire presenter's view.
Oh, I'm not being able to figure out.
The active speaker view. So when Vivek will present, you'll be able to see it. Vivek, can you show it again?
Yes, ma'am. Yeah.
Active speaker view. Where is the active speaker view?
On top right, there are three different icons that will appear. So just press active speaker view.
And perfect. Got it. Yeah, perfect.
Vivek, can you just talk and show it again so that she can see?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. Here it is.
Yeah, which visually I think it's quite interesting and it has a potential. Now I see it very clearly. Okay.
I'm using perspective in this.
Yeah, I can see that. And I can see your thought process also quite well in this. It's a very good effort, Vivek. I really appreciate it. Keep thinking and keep developing more. So what you're saying is that when you somebody who's logical is able to give arguments to support their point of view.
Yes, ma'am.
So I like the way the R is getting developed, because what you're seeing is that R is repeating. So there is a this R is echoing, basically. There is one R and there is another R behind it. Basically, it's three-dimensional, but I'm also looking at two R's at the moment. So you could look at this approach also. Right.
Yes, ma'am.
R is resonating and M is resonating, as in there is echoing of the alphabet. Because what is happening is, to support that one argument, that your point of view, you are building an argument.
Yes, ma'am.
So that is, there's a lot of potential in what you're doing. However, we need more options.
Yes, ma'am. I'll explore more.
Yeah. Perfect. Yeah. So, Krina, can now that they've understood what is to be done, can we stop this here?
Yeah.
Let them keep developing it parallelly.
Yeah.
Come up with more options.
Yes. Works.
Yeah. So, I want to now know from this class. Sorry. One second. I now want to know from the class. Is the paragraph exercise helping them to get clarity of thought? Writing a paragraph. So refine your paragraph if you think it is helping you, it is giving you further cues. Refine your paragraph today and start developing visual options. Right? And we will discuss each person's tomorrow. Krina, tomorrow we'll discuss everybody. Because everybody now needs to start developing their visuals, taking one or two.
Yeah, we could do that. We could probably take them as pairs and then go very thoroughly with all of them.
Sure.
Yeah.
Or we can create groups also.
Sure.
Create groups, because what will happen is that sometimes you've given feedback to one, it may get applied to others also, so we won't have to repeat ourselves over and over again.
Yeah, that we'll figure it out and
we will create a schedule, group schedule, and we'll share it with them so that one group can come after the other. In the meantime, the others can keep working. And nobody's, the collective time is not wasted.
Sure, yeah. So, yeah. And in the afternoon session, are we having the presentation?
The presentation, yes, definitely.
Yes.
We need to complete the presentation. This we had to do today because they have to parallelly work on a lot of things. Like they have to write the brief for the second assignment, and they have to start thinking of their company before they give a brief for the second assignment. They have to start doodling, and they have to articulate their write up, you know, all those things. And they also have an idea how they are going to be proceeding in this assignment. So they need to come. Yeah. Also, you and me, in the lunchtime, we'll discuss how they are going to be showing their sketches tomorrow. Should we make it like a lot of sketches on one? Yeah, on one. And also, Krina, I think today they've done it on the sketch copy, on the sketchbook. Let them take those copier sheets and do it.
Yeah, sure.
Because what will happen is that if they have like a softboard in their own homes, they can put up on their own softboards and see from a distance whether visually something is working or not. So it will be very helpful for them also, you know, if they can put couple of options, like if they work three iterations, so they'll be able to put it up on the board and see for themselves.
Yeah, that'll be good also, even on a wall, you know. And in fact, it'll be good for you also, because you're creating from where you start right now to towards the end what you'll be producing. So it'll be a good exercise also for you guys to see how it has progressed from this stage to the, you know, final stage. And I feel that make sure that all of the learning which has happened today in this session, the exercise, the terms that we've used, the feedback that we've given, gets applied during the presentation now. It should be much more different than what we had, you guys, the at least the three groups that presented yesterday. Now that the rest of the group has gotten all of this feedback and has heard certain terminologies, all of that needs to get applied now when you present. Okay, I hope that we get to see that. So I think group four is going to go first, right? group four.
Yeah, but so, we'll take it after lunch, no?
Yeah, after lunch. Yes.
We'll take it.
Yeah.
We'll
so we're going to now end the session here for today, and we'll resume. I think we'll resume by 2:30.
One second. I just need to ask them one question. I put a lot of resources for yesterday and for today. Have you had a chance to look at it?
Yes, ma'am.
Resources.
Okay. Yes,
are those helpful? Are these resources helpful? Okay. So we'll put for every day. So for today, I put yesterday evening only. For tomorrow, we'll put more things for you to see, read, and learn from. Okay. So this is going to happen every single day. Make sure you see the resources of the day on that day itself, because as the class progresses, as the class matures, the resources will keep evolving and the level of the resources will become higher and higher. If you don't see each one of them each day, then you will find it difficult to relate to what is being given to you. All right. So should we break for lunch? And do we want to do that thing, people sharing about themselves, or no? You take a call and let us know on the group.
A final yes or a final no. Okay, now we're not going to ask you.
We are not going to force you for anything, because both of us are on the same page as facilitators, as instructors, that the motivation of the students is the most important thing for us, because if they feel motivated, they will work. If they don't feel motivated, they'll start being absent and they will not perform. So for you to be motivated, you have to express yourself in this class. You have to tell us what you want to do and how you want to do. Instead of we being the drivers, you can also be the drivers of the class. Okay? So shall we now close the session and we meet at 2 o'clock?
2:30 preferably, ma'am, because we'll be getting probably a little stretched in the other meeting.
So in the meantime, they have a lot of work to do. They need to look at expressive typography. Preferably, I mean, with graphics also you must see, and without graphics, you have to create a repository for everyone together in that common folder which Krina had shared on the first day of the class. Give it the folder should be called expressive typography. I want one person to volunteer and create that folder. Who's doing it?
Ma'am, I'll make a folder.
Who is that? I, Sakina?
Ma'am, Sakshi.
Sakshi, okay. Sakshi is making a folder, and everybody would put references by the end of the day today. Okay. For the whole class to see and learn from. That is one thing. And you have to refine your paragraphs the way we discussed. You have to doodle. You have to think of the second assignment. Your dream company, and you have to start writing the brief for that. So you have a lot of work. Now you prioritize based on how we are proceeding in the class. You're mature enough to take a call. We are not going to say that do this first, do this second, do this third. You're mature enough to take a call how you should prioritize things. Okay? Okay. So we'll meet at 2:30 today. But and when you come back at 2:30, the groups be ready with their presentations. Okay, see you all.
Hello. দেখা হলো10:46 কেন মানে 10:50 কমছিলই তো দেখলাম আমি তো দেখছিলাম কমছিল মানে নিচে ছিল না ওটা নিচে ছিল ওই জন্য আমি যখনই দেখলাম আস্তে আস্তে নিচে নামা শুরু করে দিয়েছে তখনই কিনেছিল হ্যাঁ পুরো মিডিলে চলে আসে তখনই মিডিলে চলে আসছে তখনই নিচে সেলের জায়গাটাতে চলে যাচ্ছে আস্তে আস্তে করে তখন নিচের দিকে যেটা থাকে হ্যাঙ্গিং যেটাই নাকি কি কি বুঝতে পারছি না এখানে কি মুভিং আর মানে হ্যাঁ অরেঞ্জ কালার এন্ড লাইন হ্যাঁ কি লাইন আপনাদের সেটা আবার ডুবজি হয়ে গেছে হ্যাঁ আর আমি আমি কটায় কিনেছিলাম 1046 আচ্ছা তো আচ্ছা 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 আমার মাঝখানে উল্টোটা হবে না হ্যাঁ তো আরো আচ্ছা হ্যাঁ 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 অনেক বেশি ভালো হ্যাঁ ঠিক ঠিক হ্যাঁ 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 আচ্ছা 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 ও আচ্ছা না আমি তো মাঝখানে হ্যাঁ ও হ্যাঁ আমার তো করতেই পারলাম না সালা সেলই ঠিকভাবে করতে পার বাই সরি টার্গেট প্রাইস তো আমার কি ছিল এখানে লেখা নেই এখানে টার্গেট প্রাইসটা এক্স্যাক্টলি তো মনে নেই আচ্ছা মার আচ্ছা 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 মাথায় তো 9 টাকা মতন ছিল আমার আমার তো 10 টাকা চলে গেছিল তারপরে তো কিছু করতেই পারলাম না বাই করতে পারলাম ঠিকভাবে সতেরোশো, হ্যাঁ হ্যাঁ না সতেরো না দাঁড়াও সতেরো সতেরো আবার এটা আবার কোথায় 1723.80 হ্যাঁ ঠিক আছে আচ্ছা হ্যাঁ দেখলাম হ্যাঁ আমিও আরে আমিও তো বলছি অত দূরই আমি গেছিলাম আমিও যখনই আমি দেখলাম যে পারছি না তখনই ভেবেছিলাম কল করব নাকি কিন্তু তারপরে যখন তারপর কোনোভাবে হয়ে গেল সেলটা মানে কিছু মত ততক্ষণে আবার উপরে উঠে গেছিল হ্যাঁ ওই তখনই আমি একটু ঘুরিয়ে গেছিলাম আমি আমিও ভয় পেয়ে যে বেঁচে দেবো না কি করবো কেন আমার সেটাই আমার ভয়ই ছিল আমি সেটাই আমি আর কনফার্মেশন নিতে চাইছিলাম তখনও কল করতে চাইছিলাম যে কেন মানে হ্যাঁ 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 এটা তো এম তৈরি হচ্ছে হ্যাঁ 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 আচ্ছা 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 না তাহলে তো এম তো হ্যাঁ সেটাও ঠিকই আমি তো তাও ভেবেছিলাম আমি তখন তো এসব মাথায় আসেনি আমি মাথায় ছিল তখন যে বেঁচে দেবো নাকি তোমার তো শোনা তাও সময় থাকে ওরকম ভাবে আমাদের এই এখন ওঠা শুরু করে দিছে কিভাবে উঠছে হ্যাঁ সে তো ঠিকই হতেই পারে হ্যাঁ হতেই পারে হ্যাঁ সেটাই আচ্ছা 1154 হ্যাঁ 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 এই তো এই তো তো হ্যাঁ নিচ দিয়ে শুরু হয়েছে আচ্ছা হ্যাঁ ওই ওরকম কিছু একটা হবে হ্যাঁ আমার আমি আরেকবার আজকে জেরো ধার ইউটিউবে খুলে দিয়ে একবার প্রথমে কিভাবে বাই সেল করতে হয় ফেসেই গেছিলাম পুরোপুরি তাও তো জানি না ওই সেকেন্ড যেটা কিনে নিয়েছিলাম সেটা তো তাও ঠিকঠাক মতন মানে ওই 1 টাকা মতন প্রফিট হয়ে বেরিয়ে গেছে হ্যাঁ, আরে আমি ওটাই তো ভালো ভাবছিলাম যে ওটা হচ্ছে না কেন, মানে তুই যেন ভেবেছি ওটা করে দেখি যদি হয়, তো ওতে দেখি ভুল করে বাইয়ের জায়গায় সেলের অপশন টিপে নাকি আমি কিনে নিয়েছি। তাহলে যদি মানে কত টাকা পাওয়া যাবে যদি 7 টাকা যদি প্রফিট হয়, তো তারপরে আমার এই সেকেন্ড এসএসসি যেটা 1 টাকার যেটা প্রফিট ওটা আমি 1 টাকা লস করছি, তারপরে আমি বলতে গেলে ওই 6 টাকা 4 টাকা কিরকম করে 4 টাকা। আচ্ছা ভালোই খেলছে খেলা। বড় সড়ো প্লেয়ার হয়ে গেছে তাহলে তো এখন। না সে তো নাই, সে তো নাই, সে নাই। হ্যাঁ সে তো ঠিক, আমার কনসেন্ট্রেট করতে পারি না, আমার ওইটাই তো সমস্যা না, আমার এদিক দিয়ে ক্লাসে ম্যাম ডাকে ওদিক দিয়ে করে, ওই জন্যই আমার সমস্যা আরো বেশি বেড়ে যায়। এই যে আমি তো মাঝখানে দেখতেই পারিনি আমি, হ্যাঁ করতে হচ্ছে না আমাকে, আমাকে তো কন্টিনিউয়াসলি কাজ করতে হচ্ছে প্যারালালি আমাকে। ওর বাবা আরে কথা কি, হ্যাঁ এরকম কিছুই বলে না কিন্তু বলে যে কাজ যেগুলো যেগুলো করতে হয় তখন ইনস্ট্যান্ট করতে হয়, মানে ইনস্ট্যান্ট করে তারপরে ভিডিও অন করে দেখাতে হয় আমাদের। বলছি তো ব্যাপার আছে, অনেক কিছুই আছে, ফালতু লাগে কখন কখনো। হ্যাঁ মনে তো হচ্ছে, মানে ওরম ভাবে কিছু বলেনি আমাদেরকে, কিন্তু লেখা আছে, লেখা আছে একটা জায়গায় কি 28 থেকে ই হবে, কিন্তু এখনো পর্যন্ত পুরো কনফার্মেশন দেয়নি। হুম তাহলে তো হ্যাঁ তাহলে ঠিক আছে, তাহলে তো বলে দেবো। আচ্ছা মানে টিকিট অনেক আছে নাকি? হ্যাঁ এখন ঘরেও আমি এখনো বলিনি কিন্তু, ঠিক আছে সেটাও আগে দেখতে হবে, কারণ আমি জানি যে পাবোই না সেই। না যদি অন্য কোনো প্ল্যানও করে রাখে সেটা তো আমি যাই না, কথা বলে হয়নি। ও হ্যাঁ কুবের বলেছিল বলবে আজকে, আমি এখনই কল করছি ওকে। হ্যাঁ 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 ঠিক আছে তাহলে জানিয়ে দিচ্ছি। হ্যাঁ ঠিক আছে हाँ मैं बोल रहा हूँ कि तुम्हें फाइनली तो फिर आज का कुछ सबमिशन नहीं है ना, मतलब कल है जो कुछ भी है ना, आज तो कुछ और नहीं दिखाना। और मतलब क्या दिखाना होगा? वो आज दिखा रहा है वो, मतलब वो फर्स्ट वो जो वो वार्म अप एक्सरसाइज वाला बोल रहा है। हाँ अरे हाँ मैं वो अभी वाला सब सोच रहा था जो पेयर वाला जो है। अच्छा हाँ वो क्या किसी का भी चले, मतलब वो तीन तीन लेना होगा या अभी से एक ही लेना होगा? अच्छा एक ही लेके फिर उसका एक्सप्लोरेशन करूं, और वो जो वो राइट अप जो था उसका उसमें भी एक ही का लिखना होगा ना। अच्छा समझा। अच्छा 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 और कुछ नहीं है ना? लग रहा है वही कि टाइमली में इतना होने की एकदम इतना ही फोकस करे हाँ वो तो दिख रहा है हाँ मैं तेरा कैजुअल लुक वाला एक किया था और एक स्लिम वाला एक किया है मैं तुझे भेज रहा हूँ देख दोनों अच्छा लगता है यानी रुक जा वो कंपनी वाला ना कौन सा वो सबको करना है मतलब अभी से जो जो जिसका जिसका भी है मतलब करना है मतलब वो सबको करना है मतलब एक इंडियन ब्रांड और एक अच्छा तो फिर वो तो फिर एक साथ दिखाना होगा क्या मतलब प्रेजेंटेशन में अरे बाप रे तो फिर वो फिर से बनाना होगा मुझे मतलब कुछ पे और एक रिसर्च करके फिर से करो एक का ही प्रेजेंटेशन हुआ नहीं अभी तो दूसरे का कहा से मतलब पहले तो ये राइट अप वाला खत्म करना है मुझे जिससे मुझे मुक्ति मिल रहा है ये राइट अप का क्या 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 टाइपोग्राफी रुक जा फिर से बोल मैं भी देख लेता हूँ कौन सा वाला अच्छा एक्सप्रेसिव अच्छा मतलब मुझे सुनाई नहीं दे रहा था टाइपोग्राफी ओ अच्छा अच्छा ये क्या समझा ठीक है तो फिर समझ में आ गया ये मुझे भी बट ये नाम में हाँ ठीक है लिख हो जाएगा वही ठीक है फिर हो जाएगा अरे हाँ मैं सोचा कि अचानक कौन सा क्या आवाज आ गया फिर समझ आ गया अच्छा सकीना का था वो इतना भी चीज लाने का क्या था बाबा बहुत मजा आ रहा है तुझे तो मुझे भी ऐसे आता है खराब कुछ बोलना नहीं है छोटा छोटा ऐसा होना चाहिए तो फिर एक तो तू ही तो बताया था सब कुछ ही बता दिया था फिर से क्यों पूछ रहा है अच्छा एक तो वो जो तेरा एक्सप्लोरेशन करना है लोगों का मतलब तेरा हाँ वो और एक तो लिखना है राइट अप का और वो भी करना है वो सेकंड असाइनमेंट जो है ना वो थोड़ा सा सोचना होगा कि कंपनी क्या है मतलब किस कंपनी के बारे में करना होगा और तो प्रेजेंटेशन वो इंडियन वाला प्रेजेंटेशन हो रहा है इंडियन का कंपनी अभी वो क्या कर रहे हैं अभी ये लोग तो चूतिया है सोचते हैं पहले दिन ज्यादा कुछ काम ही नहीं दिया है इसलिए मुझे लगा कि ये लोग शायद से धीरे धीरे कर रहे हैं क्योंकि कोर्स बहुत बड़ा है तो धीरे धीरे करके देंगे काम एडजस्ट ही पाएंगे अभी तो देख मुझे दिख रहा है कि ये कोर्स थोड़ा लगाने वाला ही होगा मतलब जोर का देगा ये पता नहीं क्या है इन लोगों का हाँ रुक जा, हाँ तुझे तो मैं भेजने ही भूल गया, रुक जा वेट कर, थोड़ा मैं भेज रहा, तो एक बार नहीं भूल दे। देख ये क्या है, क्या है? अरे देख लो ना ऐसे करके अच्छा होता है।
तो बता तो कौन सा?
हाँ फर्स्ट वाला तो वो स्किन, अरे वो क्या है वर्ड ही भूल गया मैं स्किनी, हाँ स्किनी याद आया स्किनी दिखाना चाहता हूँ, स्किनी स्किनी हाँ फर्स्ट वाला जो है, और सेकंड वाले में कैजुअल दिखाना चाहता हूँ। क्या लग रहा है तुझे? मुझे तो और भी ज्यादा कैजुअल कर दिया, एकदम मोटा पतला जहाज भी, जहाज कुछ भी है
तो और
तो फिर ये रुक जा, इसमें थोड़ा काइंड ऑफ वो फेस दिखाना चाहता हूँ, एम में तेरा वो हुडी वाला फेस। नहीं लग रहा है, मतलब वही दिखाना, मतलब पता नहीं तो फिर
मेरे को कुछ यू नो क्या बोलते हैं हेलमेट
तो मुझे ये कोई भी कैजुअल नहीं लग रहा है तुझे? ओके एंड ये फर्स्ट वाला जो स्किनी वाला
स्किनी
बट थिन मतलब ही स्किनी होगा, और क्या कर दिखा मैं कैसे करके स्किनी दिखा सकता हूँ? अभी तेरा अभी यार क्या करूं, अभी
कुछ भी कर,
अभी तो फिर कैसे करके दिखा दो फिर तुझे?
तेरी मर्जी, तेरा असाइनमेंट।
हाँ ठीक है देख रहा हूँ तो फिर, और क्या बोलूं मैं।
तो देख ना वो जो मैंने बताया तेरे को एक्सप्रेसिव टाइपोग्राफी, उससे कुछ ट्राई कर।
पर स्किनिंग ये सब कैसे दिखा सकता हूँ ना, स्किनिंग का तो कोई और
तो कह रहा वो सही लग रहा है, मगर मेरे को स्किनी टर्म जो है ना उससे प्रॉब्लम, मुझे लग रहा है कोई टर्म है जो मतलब कभी कोई लोगों के लिए यूज करेगा।
और ये जो क्वाइट का, ये क्वाइट का भी कैसे दिखाऊं मैं?
वो तेरे को पता करना है।
हाँ ठीक है ठीक है देख रहा हूँ तो फिर, चल ठीक है।
blood will dry underneath my nails, and the wind will rise up to fill my sails. So you can doubt and you can hate, but I know no matter what it takes, I'm coming home, I'm coming home. Tell the world I'm coming home. Let the rain wash away all the pain of yesterday. I know my kingdom awaits, and they've forgiven my mistakes. I'm coming home, I'm coming home. Tell the world I'm coming. Still far home. I'm